Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاؤُونَ. Now when he described the salat of the munafiq, he said, number one, sahoon, they are careless to the, in the salat, where they pray it, when they pray it, and the other thing is, الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاؤُونَ. When it comes to the salat, they show the salat of, they want, يعني the good deeds they do, they want them to be seen by others. يعني there's no ikhlas in the salat. How do you know that you've done something sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake? You know that the fact that يعني when you pray or when you do something that is good, you do it seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure and His reward. If that's the intention, then that is sincerity. And what is the proof of that? The proof of that is that when you do a deed and you wish that no one saw you, that's a good sign that this deed has been made sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. الرياء الذين هم يراؤون. الرياء, showing off, is shirk. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, shall I not inform you of the hidden shirk? He said, الرياء, showing off. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم then gave an example to the Sahaba to explain to them what that means. Should understand the incredible example النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he gives. He said, this hidden shirk, which is الرياء among you, he said, أَشِّرْكُ فِيكُمْ أَخْفَى مِنْ دَبِيبِ النَّمْلِ. That this form of shirk, which is showing off and doing the deeds so you can seek the praise and the recognition of others, he said, this kind of shirk is more hidden than an ant that is crawling. He didn't say it is like an ant that's crawling. He said, it is more hidden than the crawling of an ant. So you know, if you're sitting here now, well, there's an ant that's crawling next to you, do you realize? You don't realize. You can't even see it. Well, الرياء in the hearts, it is much more hidden and smaller than that يعني, crawling ant, subhanAllah. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني, he informed the Sahaba and he said to them, shall I not teach you of words where if you were to say them, it would clear you from the inside, from the major shirk and the minor shirk? They said, بَلَى يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. What are these words? فهي said to them, say, أيوه هذا الحديث. اللهم إني أعوذ بك أن أشرك بك وأنا أعلم وأستغفرك لما لا أعلم. He says, say, oh Allah, I seek refuge in you that I commit shirk with you while I am aware of it. And I seek your forgiveness of the shirk that I fall in that I am not aware of. Anyone who says this dhikr, this dua, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, by the permission of Allah, if it comes sincerely from his heart and he says it and he continuously says it in his salat or wherever he is, that would clear him from any shirk that is in his heart, including this minor shirk that Rasulullah ﷺ described is more hidden than the crawling ant. You're concerned whether you have this or not? Say this dua, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, there is no concern that you should have. اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ أَنْ أُشْرِكَ وَأَنَا أَعْلَمْ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُكَ لِمَا لَا أَعْلَمْ. هذا هو الدعاء. Must be memorized and teach it to those يعني, who you know and who you don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاؤُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاؤُونَ. والرياء, what would also bring away الرياء from your life is to have some salat in your house. If you have some salat in your house, and then you pray, يعني, if you salat al-jama'ah in public and the people see you, then there's nothing to worry about. لأن المنافق does not have any salat in his house at all. His house is dead. No salat. والصلات in your house, it will bring so much goodness in your house. يعني مرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني he said in the hadith, I'll mention this hadith for you, but before, there was a story that Sheikh Shanqiti رحمه الله once, he mentioned to us in Al-Madinah, he said that there was a man that came to him once. And he said to him, يعني, he complained to him of problems he had in the house. He said, Wallahi, ya Shaykh, my kids, I don't know what's wrong with them. Now my headache 24/7. My wife as well, so much problems between me and her. I can't get along with her. She doesn't get along with me. I don't know what's in the house. Or maybe is it sihr? Is it hasad? I don't know what's in the house. He just seems to be, there's no barakah in this house. يعني, I'd rather be outside than inside. So he said to him, أخي, do you pray at home? He said to him, pray what? He said, yeah, salat, the sunnah, anything at home. You pray witr at home. He said, what's witr? He didn't even know what witr was. فالشيخ began to teach him, يعني there's something called النوافل, there's something called سنن الرواتب, the prayers that are prayed before and after the obligatory prayers, something called صلاة الوتر. الله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, أوتروا يا أهل القرآن, the people of Quran. And if you affiliate yourself to the Quran and you love the Quran, then you're supposed to be praying الوتر. فهي said to him these أحاديث, and he said to him, pray something in your house. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, فإن الله جاعل له من صلاته في بيته خيرا. That Allah عز وجل would make for a person from his salat in his house goodness. And he said خيرا. What do we always say about خيرا when it comes in نكرة and there's تنوين on it? يعني an abundant amount of goodness. Goodness that cannot be يعني limited or counted. For this man, he went, a few weeks he went by and he came back to Sheikh and he said to him, Wallah, I prayed my prayers, my witr, walhamdulillah, now I have some sort of salat in my house where the problems have disappeared from my house. He said to him, the children now have settled. Yani my wife and I get along on certain things. Walhamdulillah, I feel as though al barakah has been replaced in al-house. Subhanallah, hadha hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says that Allah would make for you ultimate goodness in your house when you pray in your house. For never ever cut salat from your house. Not only it will bring the goodness, but it would also save you from the quality of hypocrisy. Then the hypocrite is the one who shows off when he prays. And the one who shows off when he prays, he can't do that at home. For the hypocrite doesn't pray at home. He wants recognition from the people. For in his house, there is absolutely no salat. No salat in his house. فَأَنْتَ to save yourself from hypocrisy. With added benefits of that, pray in your house at least salat al-witr, one rak'ah at least. This is the best of a salat after the obligatory prayers. Look at the reward, what these voluntary prayers give. Imagine the reward of the obligatory prayers themselves.